Most Accurate Forecast to talk a little bit about this ever-changing weather pattern. Hey there, Kevin.
Hey, good evening, Mike and Sheree. Yeah, we continue to track, believe it or not, what has been an outbreak of severe weather that has now extended almost some 36 hours. The same storm system tonight producing tornadoes across parts of Illinois. However, before you get overly concerned, this system is going to weaken over the next few hours and will never make it here, certainly not of this intensity. But we could end up with a few passing showers tomorrow morning. Now, before you get overly worried, I don't expect a lot of rain for the morning commute, but I am going to include the chance for maybe a handful of sprinkles or a brief shower somewhere around the area to get your Wednesday morning started. Most notably, though, I think what you will notice is that it's going to be a lot milder tomorrow morning. Temperatures will start the day in the middle to upper 50s versus the 40s. It was cold if you got out early this morning. Tomorrow afternoon, a few storms will begin to pop across the area. Again, not everyone will see the rain, and I think they're going to be fairly few and far in between, but there will be a few of them around. You'll probably notice the humidity too, creeping up into the low 80s tomorrow, so not quite as comfortable as it's been the past several days. And then tomorrow evening, any storms that do pop or showers that pop in the afternoon will fade away once the sun begins to set, and it'll be a muggier evening. So the forecast calling for changes now for us. It looks like we're going to get into heat, humidity, and yes, even storms as we head into the holiday weekend, and that means a little trouble for the taste of Cincinnati too. While I don't see any day that's a particular total washout, I do believe, and I'm fairly certain, that in the afternoons and evenings, starting Saturday through Memorial Day itself, there will be disruptions to the outdoor activities because of some storms, mainly lightning, wind, and rain, typical summertime threats that we get around here when it starts to get hot and humid. Again, not a total washout, but your afternoon and evenings are likely to be impacted. So here we go. Quiet tonight, though. Look at this. Temperature's going to fall into the 50s here the next couple of hours, and we'll kind of hold in the upper 50s towards morning. All right, it's been a nice evening. 62 degrees officially at the airport. One of the reasons why those storms that are out to the west are going to weaken before they ever get here. Look at our dew point at 49. That air is pretty dry, so those storms are going to run into a lot less favorable environment for stormy weather. Temperatures around here tonight, milder than they were last night. Along and south of the river, you're still in the 60s. To the north of the river, you've already slipped down into the upper 50s. So by morning, most of us will end up somewhere between about 55 and 60. A few of you could be a little bit cooler across parts of southeast Indiana up through parts of Butler County. Nice recovery tomorrow, though. Highs back into the mid-80s for the majority of us. And again, you'll notice the humidity beginning to creep its way up. That muggy air kind of lurking down here tonight near the confluence of the Ohio and Mississippi rivers. That's actually where you still see a tornado watch currently in effect. This storm system lifting more north than it is due east, so these showers eventually are going to outrun all the energy and the instability, so that's why it falls apart as some of those showers try to move in our direction. You'll see it here. Here comes the clouds, and again, I think there's the potential for at least a couple showers around tomorrow, and then it looks like we'll probably get a few pop-up storms after 3 or 4 into the afternoon and evening, and then it gets quiet tomorrow night. But then Thursday, remember, we're transitioning towards this more summer-like weather pattern. Probably our first round of showers and storms. This wants to bring in some hefty downpours during the first half of the day on Thursday, and this will be the repeat pattern through the weekend. We'll begin becoming susceptible to clusters of showers and storms as they move through the Ohio Valley. So not as chilly tonight, a breezy night, just a few clouds around. Otherwise, nice, 58 for a low. Tomorrow, early showers, a few of them around. Again, I don't expect downpours or a deluge for the morning commute. Most of you won't see anything. A few peaks at the sun and then a few afternoon pop-ups. Here's your day planner. Given the fact that the chance for some pop-up downpours will be best during the evening commute, I've gone ahead and made tomorrow a weather impact day, but again, not everyone will see those pop-up downpours. Thursday, rain is likely. Right now, Friday and Saturday appear to be the two driest days here heading into the holiday weekend, because Mike and Sheree, I'm fairly certain that most of us will at least see some rain both Sunday and on Memorial Day itself, but not a complete washout.
Hopefully it stays away Friday and Saturday as they tape this show.